everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's this week's star of Tattletales, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you one and all for joining us here at Tattletales, and I thank Bert Convy for allowing me to be out here. And the reason I'm happy about it is because we all get a chance to see his pretty wife, Anne, and they're good game players, and they're big assets to this panel.
Thank you.
Now, as those of you who watch the show, you know that we've got our studio audience divided into three rooting sections, each one backing one of our celebrity couples. The people here in the blue section are backing Emmy Award winner.
Four Emmy Award winning
Harvey Korman and his pretty wife, Donna. How's everything between you and...
Not too good, Gene.
Not too good?
After yesterday's show, Donna really was not really greatly pleased with some of my answers.
Yeah.
And she felt that I had betrayed her, that I really was not being totally honest.
Would you like to rebut him on that statement?
Leave my butt out of this and...
He was going for a joke on the axe thing, and maybe he should finish it today.
No, because it may not get a laugh, you see, and then we're all left in the air hanging there.
But he would never take an axe to a TV set.
Yeah, but you're a pretty lady, and I love you.
Thank you.
Okay, and over here, the yellow section, your carpet leads right to Bert and Anne Convy. Hello, Anne.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good, you look just super duper.
Thank you, thank you.
Okay, are you ready to have a go at it?
I'm fine too, Gene.
You're fine too?
Uh-huh.
And you look nice too.
I'm ready to go too.
You're not ready to go, are you?
Yeah.
All right.
Right now, I think I'm better.
Now, stick around here. I'm only kidding. All right, and over here in the red section, you will be rooting for Joanne Worley and Roger Perry. Are you two still friends?
Yeah, I hope so.
I'm holding our whole act together.
Oh,
you're
you
holding
are.
Our act together?
Yeah.
And I love it.
That's not easy.
All right, now a word about the scoring. We start out with $150 in the pot, and every celebrity couple who scores shares in that pot. If only one celebrity couple scores, why then they get the whole thing, $150. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Ready.
Here, I reach over here, and I grab the first one. Nothing personal. That's all right. No. Now, girls, if you had to use only one of these words to describe yourself, would you say that you are wise, witty, or sexy? One word to describe yourself. Wise, witty, or sexy? Think about that, ladies, as we say adieu. Adieu, ladies. There they go. Harvey Korman, now don't strain yourself.
Oy, have I got trouble.
She's not too fond of you for your answers yesterday, and today
it's... Wise, witty, or sexy?
Wise, witty, or sexy?
Yes. I think Donna, in all of her self-examination, would be the first to admit that she's not... really that witty, so I think we can eliminate that.
Yeah.
Now we're down to wise and sexy.
Yeah.
No.
Listen, you can't win. You can't
win. I'm going to win.
You're going to win?
I'm going to win, yes.
No, how are you going to win? Tell me.
She is very wise, but she is also very sexy, and lately sexy is much stronger than wise.
Really?
Along with sexy.
I love it when you're angry. All right, sexy is the answer.
I just like to watch him talk.
Hold it. We're going to get Donna back here.
Mm.
There she is, Donna. If you had to use one of these words to describe yourself, would you say that you are wise, witty, or sexy?
I think I'm wise. Witty. No way I'm witty.
No, he eliminated witty.
Yeah.
And he said, you are wise. He says, but lately you've been very sexy.
But that was on the street with the streaker yesterday. And he said it was my hair.
Don't do jokes. Get the right answers.
Okay, so they will not share in the pot. Thank you, Donna.
You're welcome.
Now we'll move over to Bert here.
Oh, yes, I knew you would.
Anne is waiting back there.
I know,
but
listen.
But before we get her out here, we've got to get a response from you. Will she say wise, witty, or sexy?
You know, I'd like to be enormously amusing here, but I'm going to get killed no matter how I go. I know that. She is terrifically wise. She truly is an enormously bright person and a true partner, and I mean all that, and as drippy and sentimental as it might be, she's lovely.
Da-dee-da.
And not only that, folks, when we're alone at night, sometimes you'll say, Bert, I feel that the right thing for you to do in this life.
Yes.
No, she's
terrific. Give us an
answer. All right, she's wonderfully wise and tremendously witty. She is a very, very funny lady. So,
does she think of herself, though, as being witty? That's what we're after. Will she say witty?
Wise, they say. See, I think she's enormously sexy, too. I don't know what to do. You can't win here. What do I say?
What do you want to say?
Wise.
They're saying mostly wise.
Mostly they're saying wise.
Is that what Anne will say?
Let's go with it. It's on your heads, gang.
All right. Shh. Cool it.
Let's go with wise.
Remember, I'm a star. Stop that now.
I really would say sexy. I'm terribly. I don't want to hold
Shut
this up.
Shut up, will you? It's my show this week. All right.
We have to break away here for a moment.
Call it. Anne, come out here. Anne. There you are, Anne.
Boy, that took a long
time. We've been calling for you, and something happened.
Oh, I see.
Now, if you had to use one of these words to describe yourself, would you say that you are wise, witty, or sexy?
Well, when there's absolutely no one around to hear, I'm quite witty. No!
I told you.
He said wise.
But I also said witty.
No, Bert said you were enormously witty, and he wanted to say that, but the audience talked him out of that.
I wanted to say sexy, too, Anne.
Look at the red section go.
Well, he meant well.
That was hard. Yeah. That's impossible.
I'm sorry.
Now we come to Roger over here, who has to tell us what Joanne is going to say.
Joanne is going... She's not going to say wise. I mean, if she was wise, she wouldn't have been with me all these years.
Okay.
Can I say that she is sexually witty?
No. Witty, you can't say that.
Witty's a funny in bed.
Wittily sexual?
Come back, Harvey.
No, okay. she will say that she thinks of herself as being witty.
Witty. Audience, your rooting section thinks you've chosen the correct answer. Now, let's all be quiet as we get Joanne back on screen. Now, Joanne.
Yes?
Are you wise, witty, or sexy in your own estimation?
Well, I think very much that I'm the woman that I hope Roger did not say, but I think I would say witty.
Section is very happy because we have only one winning couple there, and they get the entire pot of $150. Okay, so at this moment they're ahead. The other teams haven't scored, and we'll see how the score goes right after this message of interest to one and all gathered on this day. Let's bring on the big board.
Television.
Yeah! Yeah! You are right.
Now, we're ready to carry on here at Tattletales, and these celebrities certainly do some carrying on, I must say. Ladies are backstage, and gentlemen are out here. Now, as you know, on Match Game, which is also on CBS, and as you know, precedes this program every day, we use questions with blanks in them, and we've adapted one of those.
We don't fire blanks on this show.
I know that. We've adapted one of those blank-type questions for Tattletales, and here it is. The question is for you girls, and you guys will have to match what they say. Here it is. One thing my guy can do better than most guys is blank. One thing my guy can do better than most guys is blank. Think about that, ladies, and we'll get back to you in a moment or so. We call on you first. How will Donna respond to this?
I'm so afraid to open my mouth.
Yes.
I am so psyched out, though.
One thing my guy can do better than most guys is...
Act.
Act? She'd
act.
Say you, she thinks you're a terrific actor.
She may
actor.
Be wrong, but that's what she would
oh,
say.
Oh, boy, is she
wrong. Would say that. I think you're a terrific actor.
Oh, thank you.
I think you're just marvelous.
Oh, Gene, come
you're
on,
just
silly
marvelous
guy.
There.
Okay. I think that's what she'd say.
She'd say that. All right, let's get Donna back. Donna, one thing my guy can do better than most guys is blank.
No shtick. I think Harvey is the best actor there is.
Folks, they kissed and made up. Okay. That's exactly what he said, Donna, you'd say. And I see you've kissed and made up, and that's terrific. Okay, and now we'll move over here to Bert and ask him what Anne will respond to.
Well, it ain't gonna be that I'm the best actor, but it's gonna be in that general area. I think she's gonna say that I talk the best.
That you're a good talker?
Talk. I talk a lot. I talk, yes.
One thing my guy can do better than most guys is talk.
I think so.
All right, now wait a minute. You were wrong last time. It's his turn to be wrong this time. So if he wants to be wrong, let him be wrong. Talk is his answer, so let's all cool it and bring Ann back. There is Ann. One thing my guy can do better than most guys is blank.
Oh, this is very difficult. He does so many things well.
Oh, I know that.
Did he buy that, Gene?
Yes, he bought that.
Okay.
Yeah.
gosh, really, he sings beautifully. I love the way he sings. I'll say sing.
Sing. You know, man, you were close. He said talk.
Oh, well.
But she's right, I do have a
wonderful
voice.
He does a lot of that.
Oh, yes. You're beautiful. Okay, so Anne, you will.
I'm sorry.
This team will not share in the pot. We'll move along here to Roger Perry.
Blow it, Roger.
How is Joanne going to respond to this?
Well, I tell you, if she's honest, you know, I'm jack of all trades and don't do any of them very well. But, you know, leading a social life, I do handle my booze very well. And
you
I
drink
would say,
well.
Drink, yes.
She's going to say, one thing my guy can do better than most guys is drink.
That's right.
All right. Cool it. Let's see.
I don't know. I saw him last
Bring
night.
Her back.
Get out.
Hold it. Bring Joanne back. There is Joanne. Now, one thing my guy can do better than most guys is blank.
Oh, well, there are so many things, but the main one I think would be, I don't know that Roger would say it, though, to make me happy or to love me. Would that count, that stuff?
Well, no, that, well, now, wait a minute.
Make love to me?
Make love to me? No, he didn't say that.
Kiss
he said,
me, hug me.
No, he said, what? You would say one thing my guy can do better than most guys is drink. That's what he said you'd say. One couple is the winner here, Donna and Harvey, and they get the bundle, the whole thing, 150. So no score there, 150, 150. Turnabout time, let's get the ladies out. Ask the gentlemen to step backstage. I will have more of Tattletales and our celebrity secrets, but first this.
Buzzer.
Now, we've done the turnabout. These pretty ladies are out here, and those pretty men are back there. And are you ready, men?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, men, if by some magical power it were possible, would you like to hear everything that was said about you behind your back? If through some magic it were possible, would you like to hear everything that was said about you behind your back? Cogitate on that for a moment or so.
I beg your pardon.
You just, while we make you fade into oblivion there for a moment or so. And there they go. Now, Donna, what say you to that? How would Harvey respond to that?
I think that Harvey would say no. He doesn't want to hear everything.
He does not want to hear everything that was said about him behind his back. All right, we'll find out what Harvey says right now. Let's bring Harvey back. Harvey, would you like to hear everything that was said about you behind your back?
Yeah.
Can you tell us why?
No. If I'd have said no, yeah, I'd have been in good shape, right?
Yeah. No, Donna said no.
I know. Well, I'm curious. I'd like to know what people are saying. I'd like to have an evaluation outside of myself. I get too close sometimes to what I'm thinking and doing and involved.
Boring.
Yeah, so there's a little logic to that. Okay, thank you, Harv. Now we move along to Anne and ask her what her response is.
Well,
what do you think Bert will say?
Bert is a very positive person, and if there's anything negative, he says, that's their problem. I think he would say, no, he does not want to hear.
He does not want to hear it?
Yes.
All right.
Yes, I say no.
He would not like to hear what is said behind his back.
No, he would not.
Okay, hold it, we'll find out. Let's get Burke back. Bert, you are back.
Yes, I'm back.
We are talking to you.
Right.
Can you hear that we are talking to you?
What's that?
Would you like to hear everything that's said about you behind your back?
To be perfectly honest, I really don't like gossip, and I try not to indulge in, and I know Anne doesn't either. And I
stop foofing around and give us an answer.
No, I wouldn't.
Okay, you gave the right answer.
Right, good.
So Anne and Bert will share in the pot. Okay, Bert, we thank you.
Thank you.
Here's Joanne.
That's
you think
hard.
Roger would like to hear everything that's said behind his back?
Golly, that really is hard. It way back in the back of your mind, it might be interesting if you could hear it and then pick and choose what you heard.
Yeah.
But just in case maybe there's something negative and bad, I don't think Roger would like to hear everything, because surely somebody's bound to say something bad. You can't please everyone, right?
So you say no.
Right. No.
Okay. She thinks Roger will say no. Let's bring Roger out here right now. And now we're going to find out your response, Roger. Would you like to hear everything that was said about you behind your back if it could be done through some magical means?
Yeah, well, you know, I figure it couldn't be any worse than what some people have said in front of my face. Yeah, sure. I think it'd be interesting.
Joanne said no, Raj.
You egotist!
She said no. So they do not share in it. Anne and Bert are the only ones who share in this pot.
Hey! I told you.
So at this moment, we've got a three-way tie. Some game, eh? Why don't you tune in a minute or so and find out how it comes out. All right, now we come to that time of the program where we double things here. Instead of playing for $150 in the pot, we've got $300 in the pot. Okay. And here we go with this question. Okay. Gentlemen, I'm going to describe three types of girls. You tell me which of them appeals to you most.
Yes.
Number one, the outdoor girl in open-neck shirt and jeans. Uh-huh. Two, the dark, curvaceous beauty in a low-cut evening dress. Or three, the sweet, helpless type in a baby doll nightgown. Shirt and jeans, dark, curvaceous beauty in a low-cut evening dress, or the sweet, helpless type in a baby doll nightgown. Think about it, gentlemen, but not too hard, because we don't have that much time, and we'll go to the ladies. Donna, what is Harv going to say?
It's really up for grabs. He likes them all, but I would choose the middle, dark, curvaceous thing.
The dark, curvaceous beauty in a low-cut evening dress.
Yeah.
And you agree with her choice?
No.
Okay.
I don't either.
No, they agree, so let's bring Harvey back and find out. Harvey.
Yes.
Have you had enough time to think about it?
Not enough time.
Okay. No, you've got to give us a response.
The middle one, the tall, dark.
The dark. You know, Harvey, it's a funny thing. The tall, skinny, attractive, beautiful, blonde lady you married to said you would say the dark, curvaceous beauty.
Oh, she said she was blonde.
That's Okay, thanks, Harv. And now we come to Anne.
Oh.
How will Bert respond?
What was that first one?
The outdoor girl in open-neck shirt and jeans.
That's it.
That's the one?
Well, that's the main one.
Yeah. You like the open-neck part?
He likes them all. Especially
he's
the
not going to say the one in the nightgown.
No, I think he likes the outdoor type.
Okay. All right, that's her decision. That's what she thinks Bert will say. Let's get Bert back here and find out right now. Bert,
yes.
Do you like the outdoor girl in open-neck shirt and jeans, the dark, curvaceous beauty in a low-cut evening dress, or the sweet, helpless type in a baby doll nightgown? Which appeals to you most?
The veins are standing out on my neck. The baby doll is out.
Baby doll is out.
That's out.
All right, you're down.
It's between the other two.
Dark, curvaceous, and outdoor girl.
It's hard. I'm trying to outthink her here, a little ESP, and I can't get a message. Come in, old wise one. I'll say the dark, curvaceous lady.
And a 50-50 50-50 chance, and you blew it,
Bert. Bert.
See how hard the game is?
Yes, yeah. See how hard the game
What's
is, Bert?
Wrong with
it's easier when you're standing out there,
blonde
but it's hard when you're back there.
Didn't say blonde. If it said blonde, I would have definitely gone. I just said outdoor type, open
outdoor
shirt
girl,
jeans.
Outdoor girl, open neck shirt and jeans.
Dark, okay. Curvaceous.
So you will not share in the pot? Thank
I don't
you,
know
Bert.
Any dark
we come to Joanne,
girls,
how will Roger respond to this?
Even though I'm terribly helpless in a baby doll,
yep.
I hope that Roger Perry will say a dark, curvaceous, low-cut, hello. I think
dark,
that
dark, curvaceous beauty and a low-cut evening dress.
Just to win.
Okay. All right, we'll see what happens. Let's get Roger Perry out here. Well, there's Roger Perry on camera right now, smiling at little cute little smile of his. Well, what do you say, Rog? Which of these girls appeal to you most? The outdoor girl in open-neck shirt and jeans, dark, curvaceous beauty in a low-cut evening dress, or sweet, helpless type in a baby doll nightgown?
Listen, if Joanne does, she didn't say this. I'm not going to let her streak anymore. And that's the dark, curvaceous, whatever.
She said Roger Perry. So, Joanne and Roger sharing this pot with Donna and Harvey, and we add to both of their scores, and we end up in a tie here. Two couples win. Donna and Harvey, the blue section and the red section. We'll get back to our celebrities and tattletales in a moment or so, but now this. Two celebrity couples are winners here today, and we've made a lot of people happy. The blue section and the red section. Donna and Harvey, $300. Joanne and Roger, $300. And that means the $1,000 will be shared, and the people in the audience will divide $1,600 among you. Well, thank you. Hey, Bert, I'm having a terrific time.
Yes, I was having a terrific time until that last question, too.
How's your marriage doing now that you're sitting on the other side of the thing there? Listen, we hope you'll join us next time for Tattletales. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.